Hello, my name is Madame Kofnus-Kotze and welcome back to my channel Booty for Booty, where I explain things. Today's topic is something that I normally don't speak about, and it is health. And I thought I will talk this time about health because I am on a health and weight loss journey, and I thought this could be a good thing. And the thing I wanted to talk about is you can make a drinking game out of it, how often I say the word thing. Is a restless leg. I suffer from it since I'm a child. Back then, and even in my teenage years, people always said, oh, that's normal. You know, that discomfort, it's from growing. And then when I graduated and I moved out and was in my early 20s, I had a really bad episode of restless legs. I couldn't sleep and it was bad. I thought to myself, bitch, you will no longer grow. You stay a midget with your 160, it's 5'2". And I decided to go to a doctor, so I went to a doctor and then to an orthopedic. I don't know how this is called in any other language. And then my journey of going to different specialists and doctors started, because I went to a lot actually. And I also did a thing that I normally would not do, and this is Google. Ask Dr. Google. But I would never suggest that. Don't do that, it's really bad. But that's what I did. And and now to the voodoo pseudoscience part of this video, because there are things where I always think that it makes it worse, but maybe it's just in my head. That's why I said it's maybe pseudoscience. One thing is weather change. I always have the feeling, but that could be because always people say like, oh, when the weather changes, I feel it, that the discomfort is getting worse. And also if I drink alcohol, that's why I actually don't try to drink alcohol at all. And when I do, I just overdo it. But in my day-to-day life, I would never just drink it. And the other thing is if I eat badly, I also have it, but that could all be just in my head. Another thing is if I don't move enough, I also get it. Or if I don't stretch or things like that. So now the pseudoscience woo-woo part is over, and things that helped me over the years is definitely stretching and walking, because I started to realize if I go on weird holidays to, I don't know, Bangkok or Japan, and I walk a lot, then because I am cheap, so I, because you know, I am a cheap person, so I do not use Uber or anything that costs money. I just go by the plane and then I walk there. And if I walk there a lot, I never have pain at night. I just go and fall asleep. So walking is really good. So that's what I'm happy. I live in a old European city, so you can walk around. The other thing is sports. I started to do sports, and this also helped me a lot. Like, I mean, I'm not really into cardio. Don't enjoy running. I'm more into weightlifting, but I still, you know, it's still something. It's not just sitting, so it's fine. And these are the things that helped me. And what is restless leg? I think I should have said this in the beginning. So what is it? Now, restless leg is a discomfort, and it can be on the whole leg, those can be at the hands, and it's very different and varies from the people. And there are two types. There are the one type that are maybe born with it, and the one that gets it later probably can be through medications. I think allergy pills, you can get it from that. Also in hormonal change by pregnancies and things like that, it can happen also like this. But they are the ones that have it, and it's mainly with women, and it's one of the most common nerve illnesses from people. And most of the patients have iron deficiency. No matter what they do, you could eat whatever you want, you have an iron deficiency. And the other thing is the lack of the dopamine, what is fun. It's fun. And the lack of dopamine is, it's that's why it's said that it's maybe related. But I since then, since the first time I read about it in my early 20s, what is a time ago? Time ago. Since then, I read that it's not, it has nothing to do with Parkinson or epilepsy. But those are the two illnesses that always get compared with restless legs, because both can happen because your body is like unable to produce dopamine, or has not enough dopamine, or the nerves in your brain are dying, and yeah, that's why. Oh, and yeah, you get depressions. If you have a lack of dopamine, you get muscle pain. It can has problems with your movement. But it's also depression. You can also have no motivation. It's hard to motivate. But it's different when you have a lack of serotonin. So those two types of depressions, I think, from the body, is I think they are different with each other. But don't quote me on that. I've tried to read a lot about it, but it's always a different thing. So these are the things. There are medications you can take. There is I think the L-dopamine test you can take, but it's not sure if you take it and restless leg stops, it does not mean that you really have it, because most restless leg patients, I am the same, have it in episodes. I mean, if you have it all the time, I could not imagine having it really all the time. I only have it in episodes, and I can have really, really bad episodes where I have it every day for weeks, and then I can have really good episodes where I barely have it. I can even have years where I nearly never have it. I have it just once or twice a year, and this is varies. So yeah, there is also medication for Parkinson that you could take. So there are dopamine medications, but those are quite strong. So your body can get used to it, and you can have problems getting off of them. It can happen then. And yeah, so most of the time you don't get any medications, and if you are the type of restless leg that has it since you are born, it says it's getting gradually worse, but it's a really slow illness, so it doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean that you have any problems when you're old. It's really, really slow. It's a really lazy illness. It just doesn't care. So that's one thing. And that the problem is, I think, with knowing if you are born with it, is that most of the time people, when you have it as a child or as a teenager, they say, oh, it's normal because you are growing. And then you're still a midget, and then you find out, maybe I'm not born with that, or maybe I'm born with that and it's not the growing thing. But I think it's very common that you just get it when you're older, and this is then a completely other story, and I can't say anything about that. I can't say anything if you get it from medication. I think it is curable if you got it from a medication, I think so. And I think also it's curable if it's some hormonal thing. For example, if you got pregnant or anything else, I think it's then also curable. But don't quote me on that, because I'm not that case. So I can't speak for the people in that place. My body starts to have such a weird type, because like everything is like, you know, and my waist, everything is like big, and then on my arms everything is small, because I have Hulk arms, or like, I don't know what the fuck I should call it. But yeah, this is my little health talk, and I thought it would be really short, but it's not. It's already at 8 minutes, and I didn't want to do that. But that was my health talk. It is a bit more serious. I will never ever hopefully do that again, but this is it. And the one thing I can always say is, if you have it, so if you have restless legs, or if you think you have it, if you can't sleep because you have discomfort in your feet and you think you have to move them, or you feel like they are turning into stone, or they tickle, or they burn, or they itch, anything that they do, and you have it more often, and it's really a discomfort in your feet or in your legs, then definitely see a professional. Like, always see a professional, and you can go to different professionals and see different answers for that. But the first thing you should definitely do is go to a professional, and do not listen to anybody on the internet, and do not ask Dr. Google. Just when you went to the doctor and the doctor said like, oh yeah, there are sites that you can look it up, then it's fine. But yeah, this is illness. It's not dangerous. I don't think that people can die of it. Like, I haven't read anything about it, but maybe I should not. And it's a really slow illness, and it's in your feet mainly, and it's just a discomfort in your feet, and it can cause problems if you can't sleep. If it went so far that you really can't sleep for a really long time, this can really affect your life and anything. And because a lot of the people who have restless legs have a lack of dopamine, it's even worse, because you are already like a person that is lacking dopamine, and then not having sleep, I don't think that's a good combination. So definitely seek a doctor. There are a lot of things that people do. I also like to use creams next to sports. I like to use creams that are warm or cold, I don't care, because the sensation that I have then, this warming or cooling feeling, is taking my mind off of the twitching of my legs. That's my video, because my cat is raiding again. And now, have a nice day, have a nice week, have a nice whatever, I don't care, your morning, daytime, evening, whenever you watch this, whenever the time is. For me, it's still October, and that's it. Bye.